Hey everybody, once again it's Tina with 85th House Vibrations and this is your general daily reading for Friday, March 30th, 2018. I hope everybody's doing well and thank you for visiting this channel. For those of you that are new, thank you so much. Glad you decided to give the video a chance, and for those of you who might be returning, thank you for hanging in there, guys. Okay, so again, we are using the witches, the everyday witch, I'm sorry. And that deck is by Deborah Blake for anybody who might be interested. Let's get started. I was asked on one of the other platforms, I'm sporting my flannel. I'm in Texas and, you know, it's a little cooler today. It's been hot. So I'm sporting my flannel, so don't judge. I've been asked about this. This is rainbow fluorite. And is that focus there? And it's fluorite, but it's got all of the colors. And this is kind of helps balance mind, body, and spirit, which is something that I've been talking about over the past couple days. And these rings are hermetite. This is rainbow hermetite. It's balancing the chakras. And this is just your black hermetite, which is, you know, helping you stay grounded and focused and helping you live in 3D if you need to. Sometimes I do. Okay. So, yeah, we're going to pull the standard three cards and figure out what the universe would like us to know for this wonderful Friday. I gotta say, you know, so far the week has really, really been positive. I think the reading for Wednesday was a little bit slowed down, but not, you know, in a harsh way. It was just, I mean, kind of take a little breaky break. So, you know, here's to hoping that we can finish this week out as strong as we started. This card just popped up. Okay. This just flipped itself over for me. And this is the Knight of Swords reversed. And I'm feeling like with the Knight of Swords reversed, this is actually a person who is, that this could be you or somebody that you're dealing with, who has something to say, has some information to give, but is pretty conscious of how they go about the delivery. You know, the Knight of Swords in the upright position is somebody who's got a whole lot to say, you know, and by George, he's saying it. He's going in for the kill, and it doesn't matter how the words come out of his mouth. You know, so far as he's concerned, he's soaring with the birds. He's high and mighty. And sometimes those words can offend people. You know, the knights don't really take a lot of time to think about what it is they're doing because, you know, this is an all or nothing type energy. In the reverse, though, you know, I think that this is somebody who's actually going to take the time to be conscious about what it is they put out there verbally. Take the time to be conscious about what it is they're thinking and how they manifest their thoughts. So let's just see what the surrounding cards have to say. I know Mercury's retrograde in Aries right now, and Mercury in Aries definitely talks about giving it to them. No holds barred. It's very possible, I'm not looking at my ephemeris, but it's possible that with the Knight of Swords reversed, that this Mercury retrograde could be at a critical degree, and this degree could be supportive of oh my goodness, a lot of energy. I'm not gonna pull all of those cards. Lots of energy, so maybe I'm on the right track, or maybe the universe is telling me to shut up. You don't know what you're talking about. But anyway, I'll check my ephemeris later and see what degree that this Mercury retrograde is at currently. All right. Because it may be a degree that supports being tactful, being conscious of what it is you say and what it is you think, tempering your words and your thoughts. So let's see what the surrounding cards have to say. The next card, let's go ahead and put those out. The next card is the Two of Wands reversed. But the Two of Wands reversed, generally, there's a coming together of energies or, making a positive decision on which way it is you want to go. But with the Two of Wands reversed, there seems to be some sort of hesitation. And maybe that's what this is. Maybe there's some sort of hesitance. Or maybe you're not picking or choosing a direction because you're not quite sure how you want to express yourself. Let's see what the last card is. The Hierophant. Okay. You know, the Hierophant, he's like the priest, the pope, the bishop. He is the traditional religious guru. He kind of follows the traditions. He's not very likely to be into or support unorthodox forms of worship, forms of spirituality. Now, in this case, though, with this card in this deck, you can see they are doing, looks like Kundalini yoga. So, in this particular deck, the Hierophant is doing something different. And at the very least, the Hierophant has got two supporters, at least two people that believe in what it is they do. If they didn't believe in it, they wouldn't be there. And they're all mimicking the Hierophant's actions. On today, you might be holding back, being hesitant, being very conscious about what you say and what you put out into the universe, because you're unsure whether or not people are going to roll with you. You're unsure about whether or not people agree. The truth of the matter is, that's not your problem. How do you feel? What do you want to do? If nothing else, you've got at least two supporters. That might be mom and dad, sister and brother, husband and friend, wife and co-worker. There's somebody out there that supports you and your vision and the way that you do things. I'm not saying that that should have any effect on what direction it is that you choose to go. But what I am saying is, I'm feeling like that on today, somebody might be feeling like they just kind of need to hold back. They're hesitant to say what it is that they need to say because it's so unbelievably different than the norm. As long as you support you is the most important thing. But the good news is, there are at least two other people that support you. And if you can reach one person, if you can make one person's life just a teensy bit better, then, you fulfilled your purpose for the day. And that's the way that I see it, guys. It's pretty short and simple. I don't know if we consider that short, but yeah, don't hold back and don't be unsure of yourself. As long as you support you, you know, when you support you, you kind of put a confidence out. You know, you kind of put that vibe of I'm confident in who I am and I'm sure of who I am and I'm good and sure I might be a little bit different, but deal with it. And when, you know, you do that and you'll find that that support that you're looking for, that confirmation, that validation that you might be looking for in other people. And even though we say all the time, oh, you shouldn't look to be validated, we're human beings and we do. We look for validation. You've got it. You may not see it the way that you want to see it at this point, but it's there. So that's the way I see it, guys. And, you know, I hope everybody has a great day. If you'd like to get in touch with me personally, my information should be included in the description box. And I hope to talk to you guys again soon. Bye-bye.